The power of nature is everywhere in this country. Water cascades off the island's volcanic rock. Limitless heat lies just beneath the cold, wind-battered surface. All Iceland's energy is generated from these renewable sources, with hydroelectric dams and geothermal boreholes.
What they've done here, and in places like this all over Iceland, is drill holes down to this superheated water about 2 kilometres underneath my feet. The steam then rushes up and powers these huge great turbines here for electricity. And of course, there's plenty of hot water left over for everyone's homes too.
Pipes and pylons march across the landscape to where the people are, but Iceland's tiny population has more energy than it can possibly use.
Iceland is now producing, we can say, 5 times more electricity than we need for the local consumption, which we are selling to power-intensive industries. We could at least double that, which means that we have 10 times more renewable electricity.
Landsverkun is examining the feasibility of laying power cables to Britain, Norway or Germany so it can profit from this huge surplus. Germany is the furthest, 1,900 kilometres away. It would cost an estimated $2.8 billion. The idea has been examined many times before, but technological advances and high energy prices have given it fresh appeal.
A cable would give us a possibility to optimize the use of our resources and to get the highest price.
Iceland may be able to use as much energy as it wants, but it's not as rich as it used to be. Its banks all collapsed in 2008, and selling power could prove a valuable export. More to the point, one that will never run out. That elusive pot of gold at the end of the rainbow. Rory Challens, Al Jazeera, Iceland.